Morning students, as you know everyone, my name is Shravan Kumar. I'm going to teach you subject Max, class 5th. Now I started third chapter, the four mathematical operations. So can you tell me what is the four mathematical operations in mathematics? You might know that we have plus, minus, multiplication and division. These are the four mathematical operations. Depending on that, we are going to do the chart. See, let's recap of 4th class. Whatever the problems is there in 4th standard, let's do that. That is the introduction. See, here I am going to write the first in your textbook is there this one. Recap of class 4. What is the question? Find the sum of the following numbers. So let me take here the total three problems is given. I would like to explain you two. Remaining will be the homework. 34,567 and 89,176. This is I would like to explain you, and I would like to explain you B also. 45,123 and 70,138. See this problem, let's do this addition, right? Sum how you will do here is, let's do according to place value chart. You can understand easily. The ones place ones, thousands places thousands. So ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. So let me make to understand. Ones, tens, hundred, and what do you write? Thousand, 10,000, right? So here you see, here 5 digits, here 5 digits. So that's why. So making you to understand this one. So making the box. For your understanding purpose only, I am doing this one. So try to understand it clearly. So here I am making the box. You can understand easily. This one more will be get. This is the result answer. See, you may get doubt. See, if you understand clearly, you can understand it. See, the first one, what is the ones place number digit is there? 7. Let me write 7. Next thing, a tens place 6. Hundreds place 5. Thousand place 4. 10,000 place 3. Next one, ones place 6. Tens place 7. Hundreds place 1, thousand place 9, 10,000 place 8. What the question is saying is, find the sum is it. Sum is nothing but plus. In this box, I am writing the plus. Means we are doing the addition. So now, how you will do? 7 plus 6. What you will get? 7 plus 6, 13. If you add it, 3. Yeah, one will be the carry, right? So once add it, 1 plus 6, 7, 7 plus 7, 14, 1 carry, 14 means 4 you return, 1 is a carry. 1 plus 5, 6, 6 plus 1, 7. So no carry, let it be like that only. 4 plus 9, 13. 13 means 3 here and 1 will be the carry. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 8, 12. Right? So, what is the answer of this? You will write, this is the answer to you. Means, what you will tell? You can read it. The ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh. Means, 1,23,700. 43 is the answer
to you.
Similarly, we go for B. You can understand easily, right?
So solution.
See, same like box only, let's make. See, ones concept, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. Means up to 10,000 we have to take it. Ones, tens, hundred, hundreds, thousand, 10,000. I'm making the box. So depending upon the problem, values will be changes. If it is six digits, so you will write lakh also. So make the box to you understand. Means orderly we are writing clearly. So the first, this one we need to take. 3, 1's place, 10's place, 2, 100's place, 1, 1000 place, 5, 10,000 place, 4. And your second one, 8, 10's place, 3, 100's place, 1, 1000 place, 0, 10,000 place, 7. Means what we are doing? Addition. So plus. Let's add it. 3 plus 8, 11, 1, 1 will be the carry. 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 3, 6. 1 plus 1, 2. 5 plus 0, 5. 4 plus 7, 11. So, if you want to write clearly, 45,123 plus 70,138 answer will be, you will write 1,15,261. Isn't it right? So once you focus on it, here also let's write like it only. 34,567 plus 89,176. So what is the answer? You got it? 1,23,743. Once you focus on it clearly, two problems. See here, one more thing. See, I am making two boxes. Do you understand? This is the result to you. Why? Because both are same. Means you will get the doubt, right? This is the result. I am making two boxes. Then you can understand. This is also, I am making two boxes. This is the answer. So try to concentrate on it. Answer. So that will be the answer to you. The next we go for second bit. What is the second bit? Here is, let me write the second bit. What is the second bit? Find the difference. Find the difference of the following. Find the difference of the following numbers. So here also I would like to tell you two problems remaining. Total three are there. I would like to explain you two. One more will be the homework. First one I am writing 41,537 and 38,915. Then second one I would like to explain you, 81,567 and you will like 65,138. These problems we are going to doing with difference, finding the difference of the problem. So here also you have to understand it clearly. So same, First of all, you concentrate on the same digit numbers or not? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First thing. And this is greater. So 41,537 is a greater. So first unit, right? So solution out. So 5 digit numbers, similarly, same I'm making as the ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, making you to understand. 1, 2, this is the result. This is the result box. This is the result box to understand. Why? Because you will get the both as. So this is the what operation we are going to do. We are doing subtraction, right? And observe it clearly. So what is there here in the first one? 1's place 7, 10's place 3, 100's place 5, 1000 place 1, 10,000 place 4. Next year 1's place 5, 10's place 1, 100's place 9, 1000 place 8, 10,000 place 3. Is it clearly difference? Difference is nothing but subtraction. That's why we are doing the subtraction. See, from bigger to smaller we are doing subtraction. 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5. If you don't know, you're all and 7 lines you write it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In that you cancel 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What are left here is a? Like this also, you can remember it. Then, here is a 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1. How you will do, right? 3. 1, 2, 3. And you are minus 1 here. Cancel. What are left here is a? Then here is the problem. Smallest number you are subtracting highest number. So you need to take the borrow from here to here. So it will become 15. It will become 15. So from 15 you are subtracting 9. So 15 like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. In that, how many you are subtracting 9? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And so many left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 6. Here, you took borrow from here, right? So it will become 0. This value will become 0. This will become 0. This is cancelled. So 0 minus 8, can you subtract? No. So again you are taking borrow from here. So it will become 10. Then it will become 3. So this 10 minus 8, we all know easily 10 minus 8 is 2. But you understand 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In that 10 you are subtracting 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How much left? It's a 2. Here is a 3, right? 3 minus 3, 0. So answer of it, 41,537 minus 38,915 is equals to 2,622 is the answer. Once you concentrate on it clearly, I would like to explain the next problem. Then we go for second B. What is here? Similarly, here is also 5 digit numbers. So here will be zeros. What do you write next? Tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000. Making the box. This is the last one is the, I am making two boxes to understand you, because it is the result answer. It is the result answer. What we are doing? We are doing subtraction.
So 81,567. Next 65,138. Why I can fast? You are all understood how to write this one. So that's why. So can you subtract 7 minus 8? It's impossible. Why? Because 7 is a smaller of 8. So we are taking borrow from here to here. So it will become 17. Become 17. Then it will become 5. 17 minus 8. How you will do? If you don't know lines, you write it, you get out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. In that 8 you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here is the 9. Then 5 minus 3, you can subtract it. 5 is a greater, right? So 5 minus 3, you will write 2. Simple. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. So what are left? Is it? Again, here also you can subtract. Simple, we know 5 minus 1, 4. Here also it is impossible to you because 1 is the smaller of 5. So we need to take the borrow from here. So it will become 11. Then it will become 7. 11 minus 5. You will get down. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And you are subtracting 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How much left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you are in the 6. And here is the, what is there? Here is the 7. Why? Because you took the borrow. So 1 will be the less. So 7 minus 6. Answer is the 1. So what is the answer? You will write here is 81,567 minus 65,138. His answer is 16,429. Once you concentrate on it clearly, everyone. So, what are the homeworks are there? I will write the year. So, I hope you are all understood clearly. So, once you make it clearly, try to understand it. Once you concentrate on it. Okay, my dear students, here is, I am writing the homework, note it down and make it do at home. So, here is I am writing. See, the homework is, what is the homework is? First bit. What is the first bit? Find the sum of, find the sum of the following numbers. What is the question is? C. In this C. What is the C is? 41,567 and 20,106. And second one, find the difference of the following numbers. Here also see. Let's see, I did not explain that you are doing as a homework. 43,567 and 21,345. This is the homework, my dear students. I hope you will do everyone. So make it noted down and maintain the classwork clearly. Thank you very much, my dear students.
Hey, good morning, children. We are completed the third lesson. What is the third lesson? Rocks and minerals. Okay, in this I gave the keywords. Yes, tick the correct answers completed. Click the banks completed. Now I'll give the third bit, C bit, that is complete the series. Okay? Take your glasses and write on better. Write the lesson in beta. Already you have completed A bit, B bit. Now we are doing for C bit beta. Okay, C bit.
Okay, then gold, metal.
and diamond gemstone. They are very costly and rare using. Okay. Say once again with me. Pumice. It is pumice igneous shale sedimentary. Okay. SEDIMENTARY sedimentary. Okay. Next, limestone, marble, granite. From granite, gneiss. 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 Next, shale, slate, sandstone, quartzite. Sandstone, S-A-N-D, sand, S-T-O-N-D, stone, sandstone. Next, iron, hematite, aluminium, bauxite, B-A-U-X-I-T-E, bauxite, B-A-U-X-I-T-E, bauxite. Next, gold, metal, diamond, gemstone, G-E-M-J-M, S-T-O-N-E, stone, G-E-M-J-M, S-T-O-N-E, stone. Copy. Next page, you go to next page, repeat, okay? Okay, now G bit, this question and answers are same beta. D bit and E bit are click the mail. Now think and answer. D bit, E bit and F bit are sent in the WhatsApp beta. Now you go to we'll go for the do and learn. G bit will go.
Using the clues given below. Okay, first one, this thick black liquid, is formed deep underground and can be refined to obtain many products. Dash. Second one. These rocks are formed by the cooling of lava and magma. Third one, this rock is monthly made, of the mineral quartz. Fourth one, sedimentary rock. Sorry, this sedimentary rock. Is used as a tool dash. Fifth one, this rock is used for use in the construction of frogs. Okay, now we go for the answer set. Okay, so say for me first one, the thick black liquid is found deep underground and can be refined to obtain many products. What is that? In the sea, you can see better. What is that? Petroleum. Yes or no? P-E-T-R-O-L-E-U-M. Petroleum is found under the ground. Under the ground or in the seas. Yes or no? It can be refined to obtain many products. This petrol will come and you can use for what better? For car, buses, train. Yes or no? Yes. This petroleum comes from the underground. Okay. Next one. Said these rocks are formed by the cooling of lava or magma. What is that? By cooling the lava and magma, what will form? Igneous rock. What is that? Igneous rock. Igneous rock will form. Yes or no? Yes. Next one. This rock is mostly made of the minerals. That is quartz. What is that? Sandstone. Yes or no? Sandstone is way better. Sandstone is mostly made up of the mineral quartz only. Next one. The sedimentary rock is used as a fuel. This rock is used better. For what? Fuel. What is that? Coal. Coal is used as a fuel. No? Yes or no? Coal is a sedimentary rock. It is used as a fuel. Last one, the rock. This rock is used in the construction of rocks better. Construction of road, sorry. Construction of roads. What is that? Basalt. Basalt rock. I think all of you have seen these rocks. Small rocks are there. Yes or no? That they will build for construction of the rocks. Okay, say with me. The this thick black liquid is found deep underground and can be refined to obtain many products. What is that? Petroleum. P-E-T-R-O-L-E-U-M. Petroleum. It comes from the underground. Okay. These rocks are formed by the cooling of lava. By the cooling of lava, which rock will form better? Igneous rock. I-G-N-E-O-U-S. Igneous rock. Okay. Next one. This rock is mostly made of the mineral quartz only. Which rock? That is sandstone. Yes or no? In sedimentary rock, we are seeing the sandstone. Yes sir? Yes. S-A-N-D. Sand. S-T-O-N-D. Sandstone. This sediment rock is used as a fuel better. This sedimentary rock is used for what better? For fuel. Which rock? That is coal. It is in black color. Yes or no? I think all of you have seen this coal. Yes or no? Yes. And for this from this you can get the electricity also. So what is the spelling? The sedimentary rock is used as a fuel. It is C-O-A-L, coal. What is the spelling? C-O-A-L, coal. Next one. This rock is used in the construction of roads better. I think all of you have seen how the construction of roads are doing. Which rock? That also you know. What is the rock name? That rock name is basalt better. B-A-S-A-L-T. Basalt. B-A-S-A-L-T. Basalt. this the type in the page number 29 given beta. Page number 29 this given beta. Complete the word puzzle. So how I gave like this, you write the serial number C and write the answers beta in the boxes, okay? And this is one make your own rock museum beta. You collect some different types of rocks from your garden and okay, famous for the sculptures and recycled ceramics are there, okay? Till here we are completed beta. See, D bit, E bit and F bit I'll send in the WhatsApp beta. In mail I'll keep. And this you complete in the classwork. Homework, this is in the homework beta. This C bit and G bit you have to complete in the textbook, okay?
Okay, I'll do the homework beta. Same homework. In textbook beta, right? Textbook page number 28 and 29. C bit and G bit beta. C bit and G bit. Okay? This is the homework beta you have done in the homework. Okay? Okay, thank you children.
That's why it will fall slantingly, right?
right? Like this. Here also, like this. Planting it will fall. But when it comes to equator, it will fall straight. The sun rays will fall straight. Here only less space, but the same amount of rays. But here so much space, so that's why near the equator it will be very hot. So, see, depending on the amount of heat received, there are three climatic or heat zones on the earth. So, depending on the heat it is receiving, here we are receiving heat from the sun, no? So, depending on the heat we received, that we have three climatic zones, ma. Three climatic or heat zones we have. That first one is the torrid zone. The torrid zone. Depending on the heat they received on the earth, we have three climatic conditions, three climatic zones, heat zones. First one is the torrid zone, beta. So I will explain what is mean by the torrid zone. The area on both sides of the equator between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn is called the torrid or tropical zone. See, the area on both sides of the equator, here we have equator, no? Yes, we have Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, right? So, the area on both sides of the equator between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn is called the torrid zone, or also we call it as tropical zone. Where we call? See, the area on the equator, see, above the equator and below the equator, we have Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn. So, this area we call it as tropical zone or the torrid zone, okay? The word torrid means extremely hot. As it lies near the equator, this zone receives maximum heat. So here we are saying torrid. What is mean by torrid, beta? It means that it means extremely hot. Extremely hot. What is mean by torrid? Torrid means extremely hot. Why we are saying it as torrid zone? Why? Because here when we see the sun rays are falling straightly, that means this area will receive maximum sun heat from the sun. Maximum heat from the sun. That's why it is extremely hot. That we call it as the torrid zone. The area between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, whatever the area is there, we call it as the torrid zone. What is mean by torrid here? Extremely hot. Why it is hot? Why? Because this area is nearer to the equator. So here the near the equator the sun will fall, sun rays will fall straightly. That's why it will receive the maximum heat. That's why we call it as the torrid zone. It will receive the maximum heat. Extremely hot. Here whatever the countries and region is there, it is extremely hot. It will receive the maximum heat from the sun. Okay? This zone maximum. It is hot throughout the year here. See here. Near this earth, in the torrid zone, whatever the areas, whatever the regions are there, it will be hot throughout the year. It will be hot throughout the year. Why it is hot? Yes, we know the reason. Why? Because sun rays are falling straightly. That's why the area, this area will receive maximum heat from the sun. That's why this area is hot throughout the year. Okay, na? The tropical or the torrid zone. Here, can you see picture? Yes, this is the tropical or the torrid zone. This is the area from the tropic or the torrid zone, ma. Okay, na? So, what we learnt in this torrid zone? Yes, the area between Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, whatever this is there, we call it as the torrid zone. Okay, near to the equator. Here, near the equator, the sun rays will fall straight. If the sun rays are falling straight, means they will receive maximum heat from the sun. That's why this area is very hot. That's why we name it as the torrid zone. Here, what is mean by torrid, ma? Extremely hot. So, whatever the regions are there in this place, they are extremely hot throughout the year. Okay? Now, torrid zone is completed. First one. next one is temperate zone. The temperate zone. Okay, we completed about the torrid zone. Completed, no? Next we are moving to the temperate zone. So what is mean by temperate? Where it lies, we will see. The areas that lie between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle in the Northern Hemisphere and the Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle in the Southern Hemisphere is called as temperate zone. Here I'll show you, ma. See, this is, see here. Yes, the areas that lie between the Tropic of Cancer. Where is the Tropic of Cancer, ma? Here we have Tropic of Cancer, right? And the Arctic Circle. Where we have Arctic Circle? Here. So, Arctic Circle, Tropic of Cancer. This is temperate zone, okay? The areas that lie between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle in the Northern Hemisphere. This is Northern Hemisphere, no? Now, Southern Hemisphere. In the summer, the Southern Hemisphere, Tropic of Capricorn. See, the areas that lie between the Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. See, this we call it as what we call? They are called temperate zones. See, Arctic Circle, Tropic of Cancer. The area between the Arctic Circle and Tropic of Cancer in the Northern Hemisphere. When it comes to Southern Hemisphere, the area between the Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. These zones we call it as temperate zone, okay?
This region has a mild climate, neither very hot nor very cold. So, how the region will be? This region will have the mild climate. Mild climate. What is meant by mild climate? It means that not very hot, not very cold. Not very hot. Not very cold. Okay, this region will have the mild climate. It means it is not very hot, not very cold. This will have the mild climate. Okay, so temperate zone. Here I'll show you.
A temperate forest in Australia. So Australia will lies under the temperate zone, beta. So here this is a forest from the temperate forest in Australia. Okay. Next is the frigid zone.
Two zones we completed, no? Now, third one. The frigid zone. What is the third one? The frigid zone. So, what is meant by the frigid zone? The area between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere. And between the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole in Southern Hemisphere receive very little heat from the sun. They are very cold and large parts are covered with snow throughout the year. They are called the frigid zones. Here, already I have explained with them. Near the poles, they will receive the small amount of heat from the sun. Why they will receive small amount? Why? Because here the sun rays will fall slantingly. That's why near the poles they will receive the less amount of heat from the sun. That's why these are covered by the snow throughout the year. The poles, near the poles, whatever the regions, whatever the places are there, they are covered by the snow throughout the year. So which places they are? See, I'll show you.
See. The areas between the Arctic Circle, where is the Arctic Circle, ma? Here. The areas between Arctic Circle and the North Pole. Here, can you see up we have North Pole, right? The frigid zone, ma. The area between the Arctic Circle, can you see here Arctic Circle and North Pole here in the Northern Hemisphere and the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole. We have Antarctic Circle and the South Pole, no, near the poles. So this region we call it as frigid zones.
What we call frigid zones? One more time I will read. The areas between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere and between the Antarctic Circle and South Pole in the Southern Hemisphere receive very little heat from the sun. So already we discussed, near the poles they will receive very little heat from the sun.
Okay, they are very cold and large parts are covered with snow throughout the year. So here the place is very cold and they will receive the snowfall. Snow will be there. Mostly the parts are covered by the snow. Okay, they are called the frigid zone. So we call it as frigid zone. Okay, ma. Now I will show you. See, ma. This is globe. This is equator. Here we have north pole. Which pole we have here? North pole. And here we have south pole. Yes. And see here. This is what? This is Arctic Circle. Arctic Circle. Again, what we have here? Antarctic Circle. What we have here? Antarctic Circle. Yes, this is Antarctic Circle. Again, here we have Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Capricorn. This is in the southern hemisphere. And here what we have in the northern hemisphere? Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer. Yes, we already learned, no, in the previous lesson. So, torrid zone. First zone, what I said, beta? Torrid zone. Which is the torrid zone? The area on both sides of the equator between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So, this area will comes under the what, ma? This area is called as frigid zone. What we call it? We call it this area as frigid zone. Why? What we discussed, the area between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, we call it as frigid zone. Okay? And next what we learn? Temperate zone. What is temperate zone? The areas that lie between the Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle. Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle, right? I'm showing it with the dots. Okay? This we call it as what we call temperate zone. This is temperate zone, right? This is temperate zone. And here also, the area between Antarctic Circle and Tropic of Capricorn, what we call temperate zone. Okay, temperate zone. Again, what we learned? Frigid zones. The area between the Arctic Circle and North Pole. Arctic Circle and North Pole. I'm symboling with the stars, ma. This we call frigid zone. What we call? Frigid zone. Why? Because they are nearer to the poles. These are the frigid zones. Okay? Antarctic Circle and South Pole. Okay? This is frigid zone. So, here the area, first one is torrid zone, no? The area between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, whatever the area is there, this is called what, ma? Sorry, torrid zone, not frigid zone. Torrid zone. Okay, the area between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn, we call it as torrid zone. Torrid means what? Extremely hot. See here, it is nearer to the equator. Near the equator, sunrise will fall straightly. That's why the region is very, very hot. That's why torrid means extremely hot. The area between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn is torrid zone. Next, which zone we have? Temperate zone, right? So, both sides. See, the area between Arctic Circle and Tropic of Cancer is temperate zone. In the southern hemisphere, the area between Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle is temperate zone. Okay, completed. Next week zone we have frigid zone. So, in the northern hemisphere, the area between the North Pole and Arctic Circle is a frigid zone. And in the southern hemisphere, the area between the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole is called a frigid zone. Okay, ma? So, they are called the frigid zones. One video note box is there. After that, I will stop my lesson and I will give you hard words. The North and South Pole experience 6 months of day and 6 months of night. Places within the Antarctic Circle, like parts of Norway and Greenland, where the sun stays in the sky throughout the night day, they are known as the land of the midnight sun. See here. They are given, did you know, box here. So, near the poles, beta, how many poles? 2 poles we have, no? So, near the poles, they will experience the 6 months of day. Means, sun will rise for 6 months continuously. And 6 months of night.
Okay, so places within the Arctic Circle like parts of Norway and Greenland where the sun stays in the sky through the night and day. So 6 months of day means what? In the night also sun will stay. Are known as the land of the midnight sun. So that's why these places are known as the midnight sun. Why? Because 6 months of day means what, beta? 6 months continuously sun will be there. See, for us, night time sun will go, no? But here near the poles, the sun will not go. That's why here, whatever the places are there in the parts of Norway and Greenland, we call them as midnight sun. We call it as midnight sun. So what we completed, only distance from the equator, in that we completed torrid zone, frigid zone and temperate zone, right? Now I will give you the hard words, okay? Okay, write the first one now, that is torrid, T-O-R-R-I-D, torrid. Second one you write tropical zone. T-R-O-T-I-C-A-L, tropical, Z-O-N-E, zone, tropical zone. Third one, you write temperate zone. Temperate zone. Fourth one, you write frigid zone.
Up to there only reading the textbook.